What a glorious day. Aren't we lucky?
Come on, quick, guys. Hector needs to talk. Come on, quick. Quick, it's going to start. Gerald, you're up. You're up, buddy. Right, if everyone wants to take their seats, conversation's over. Oi, you anarchist. Can you stop talking?
Right, Gerald's going to start.
Anarchist, stop talking. Right, everyone, I'd like to introduce Hector on the right, Gerald on the left. They're going to talk about GMO in the UK. Obviously going to be very contentious. Please save your questions to the end and make them good. All right, round of applause for Hector and Gerald, please. Thank you very much.
Okay. Well, good afternoon.
Mics are...
It's very good of you to come out on a day like this. You've got nothing else to do, so you've come here to listen to us.
There's your mic.
My name is Gerald Miles. I'm an organic farmer from Pembrokeshire, and I've been campaigning with a lot of other wonderful people against GM crops for over 10 years in the UK. Now, if I give you a bit of past history to start off, back in the late 90s and to 2003, there were crop trials being done in the UK. These were trials of oilseed rape and maize that were grown in various parts of the UK. They started off with about 250 trial plots to about 60 in the end. In 2003, there was a big demonstration. They called it the tractors and trolleys, where everybody from all over the UK, the campaign groups, travelled to London in different modes of transport. And I drove my tractor all the way from Pembrokeshire to London.
How long did it take, Gerald?
It took 8 days. So. And I must say it was quite enjoyable. We had a wonderful demonstration of about 2,000 people to number 10 Downing Street. This was a wonderful demo, good feeling. We thought we'd achieved something. But at the time, Tony Blair, who was the Prime Minister, he allowed commercialization of GMAs in the UK. But as well, at the time, Syngenta pulled their offices out of the UK, stating that it was impossible to promote any GM crops in the UK. At the time, the media and people thought we'd won. Well, I'm afraid it's back. This government, and especially Paterson, is promoting GM crops in the UK. They have now turned the two research stations we have in the UK, the John Innes Centre in Norwich. They're doing trials there on GM potatoes, creating them resistant to blight. We've already got varieties that are naturally bred against blight, so why are they wasting 1.3 million doing this research? In Rothamsted, they're doing research on GM wheat. Possibly you've heard about it last year when we had a campaign against it. They're creating a wheat resistant to aphids. They're changing the DNA of the wheat by inserting two antibiotic resistant genes, a peppermint gene and a synthetic cow gene. They've done no feeding trials on this, yet they're doing an open air trial on it. Feeding trials mean that they should have fed them to rats beforehand to find out what's the point of creating something and putting it out in an open trial when really you're not sure whether there's any benefit in it, if it's any good in your food. They're trying to say that, well, there's no need. When we were interviewed last year alongside a scientist from Rothamsted, they said there was no need for feeding trials. So this is what we're up against. Lately, last September, a scientist from France, Professor Giles Eric Seralini, He released results of his trials. He'd done a trial over 2 years, feeding 200 rats with GMAs. The consequences and the result of this was that 86% of the rats died of massive cancer tumors. This has really rocked these corporates. They've tried to disgrace him, they've tried to take his research apart, saying that the data isn't correct, saying that he's not using the right rats. He used the same rats as Monsanto used in the research. He tried to do it the same, in the same pattern. What we're faced with is when we're getting commercialized crops in that are licensed by Europe, they approve these crops on the research given by the company that's selling the actual seeds. And they only have to do research over a period of 9 months. Seralini found that after feeding them for 2 years, it was only after 10 months that cancer tumor started to form on these rats. So this is a question that this can cause us harm. This is something that they should be looking into. They should ban all GM crops now. This is what we should be really fighting to and campaign to stop. In September, this September, we're bringing Seralini over to the UK. He will be speaking in London, and he'll be speaking in Cardiff and Scotland. So I'll pass these cards around to you so you can be aware of the date and to come and see what he has to say. But these are the things that we are really up against. And really, we need you to be aware of what's happening. Otherwise, we are going to lose this battle against GM crops.
Before the cancer actually forms. So when they say it's nothing happens, there's no cancer, it's clear, it's because they don't take it beyond that point, which is what Seralini's done. I think it's really important for the public to realise that. We've never heard the truth before. Not in this sense, other than from Abai Putsai.
Yeah.
Thank you.
No, that's true, because they stopped these trials after 90 day. You see, if you're taking medicine, it takes nearly 5 years of research before you actually consume or are able to buy the medicine. GM crops can be introduced and be as a seed for you to sow within that 90 days, after that 90 days research. So really, it's totally irresponsible. Now then, I'll hand over to Hector and I'll come back in later. Okay.
Sorry, can I just wanted to ask another question. Sorry, I'm over here. Hey, that's all right. I don't know actually very much about the research into GM crops at all, but I wondered how many long-term trials there had actually been, aside from this one study. I'm presuming there are many different ways of genetically modifying various different crops. Normally you have to do quite a lot of trials before. I'm not saying that you're wrong in what you're putting forwards, but I just wondered whether there had been multiple repeated, well-tested, confirmed studies on, you know, all the different strains that are out there, or if we're just at sort of the beginning of looking into this.
There have been quite a few independent research done on this, because one well-known one, possibly you don't know about it, it's the a research that was done back in 2001 by Albert Putsai, Professor Albert Putsai. He was a scientist in Inverness University, and he was requested, he had a commission from Monsanto to create a potato resistant to aphids. So what he created, he used the flower snowdrop, and he used the DNA of the snowdrop and induced it into the potato DNA. Now, being a practical scientist, He made his own research of feeding rats. He did his own feeding study. So he had three batches of rats. He fed one natural potato. He fed the second one with GM modified potato. And the third one, he fed the juice of the snowdrop. He made a press release of this.